spinning wheel, like a snowball down a mountain, or a carnival balloon, like a carousel that's burning, running rings around the moon, like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its fate.
The difference.
And the world is like an apple whirling silently.
Well, I think that we don't talk much about an evil neighbor, an evil creature who sits in somebody's midst and just provokes, put everybody in doubt. An evil nation who just goes around and attack and blame all the others, try to keep, well, some kind of, you know, hidden control over and above everybody around. So, to talk about evil is not so evil as many people would say. Don't talk evil. It would be like better not to mention what other people or other creatures did to you, that you did some evil things to another, that you did some, let's say, not so evil things, yet you said them, you told them, you wrote them, and then what? So tell them. When evil becomes an opportunity, then you know you made it. I'll share with you a dream and vision, or dreamision, that I had last night. It was 702 beings, basically cleaning the dark tombs underneath, deep down underground, where we found, honestly, in tens of millions of skeletons of, let's say, spirit cocoons hanging like moth balls all over the ceiling. And these tombs were sizes of, let's say, the theater, sizes of the big baseball stadium. So, not a nice and gentle place to be. Smells on fear, smells on death. A lot of, let's say, creatures, they don't even want to know why they're there. They still think they are alive. They still hang to their skeletons, to their bones. By Vatican and many others in France, churches have almost like rooms built of human skulls, and they're very proud of it. Yet nobody is telling you, let's say, in details, they don't tell you anything, but if somebody tried to tell you in details, what does it mean when you walk over human skulls? You can see my intro photo that I found. This is exactly this evil creature that made us cherish and almost be in awe of death. And as well, another layer in the finances, we've been cherishing to live in debt, meaning owning the money to somebody else, mostly to the banks. So when you realize that every single bone, every single skull, every single location where blood is spilled, it carries a frequency of evil, carries a frequency of raping another soul. When the swords and knives and bombs and explosions and killings, especially the mass killings, were perpetrated over the humanity, these locations remains intoxicated for everybody around, and to the point of that it's intoxicated towards an art. So many of these so-called mass killing places, many of the mass killing events happened on a very particular location where energetically Earth was, let's say, hooked. It was like fished into its energetics. Until now, 3 years, when Prime Creator removed the 12 source energy from the planet completely, because it was there, it was placed for the benefits of the humans. So we can, almost like invisible energetic grid of source energy. But this was hijacked, this was stolen. We never had a chance to utilize it. Some of us utilized to the point. Yet 100% of population were just, let's say, plugged into this, and then the wiring between the source energies and the physical body of the human has been hijacked. So you receive just a fraction, so you can barely make it to your 80s, 90s or so, if you're not killed now in accidents, in the wars, in the previous, let's say, generations, mass killings happened as plague or any kind of, you know, ill-organized deeds, tsunamis and so on. To me, all these events that we experienced just in last 15 years, 20 years, if you just go back, every of these wars, every of these big tsunamis, every of these, let's say, big fires or storms or hurricanes were not human-made, and they were not God-made, and they were not nature-made. They were made by these evil critters who we now pretty much completely eradicated. Now we have to deal with, let's say, the leftovers of our ancestors, of our own lost lives, bodies, incarnations, limbs, blood, sacrifices, generation after generation after generation. I'm doing clearing together with Denise, and I'm on the 27th generation based on my ancestry. And I have 67 million grandmas and 67 million grandpas. So 128 million ancestry links to my physical body. And this is only 27th one, and doesn't reach even, you know, 700 years from now or before time. So imagine that we have to go at least 4,000 years in the past to clear what we're carrying. How many generations we have to clear? How many grandmas and grandpas we have to clear from our physical body? So then we can absolutely start living the true meaning of earthly and never-ending life. Otherwise, we'll be dying as everybody else. But this dying before was hooked into the planet. It was poisoning the planet in itself. So as many of the wars, as many of the calamities starts coming around and happening over and over and over, were there just to enslave the planet itself. Yet we free this notion. There is no more mass sacrifices. There is no more massive raptures that were happening, so-called, in the previous civilizations. And these are not raptures from God. These were raptures from the fake God. So now, or from now, when I talk about God, I will just say God. Even if in reverse, you can read it as dog, but evil, you can read it as live, in reverse. Yet means not much if you don't recognize it, but as soon as we recognize that God, the one that he puts himself as a dog in your face, pretending that he will, let's say, save you, but only when you die. Not telling you all the details in the contract with a small print, where we absolutely end up enslaved even after our death, after our another death, and after our death, after death, after death. We've been enslaved in so many layers, in so many instances, that it's almost unfathomable for me when I put the numbers. After 49 generations, we have 1.4 gazillion grandmas and grandpas, or ancestry to be clear. It takes me about, for 67 million grandmas, it takes me about a month, and 5 days, if my computer is not attacked, if the the dark ones are not trying to, let's say, influence or break some of my timeline crashing and the healings that I'm doing through online. Yet, if you're interested in this, how you can join, how you can become part of this, really a beautiful and selfless team that is going around and clearing all the ancestry, well, theft of the spirit, and in capturing the soul in, let's say, so-called spirit boxes, or fraction of your soul. So these are these cocoons that I've seen in my dream, and they were in hundreds of millions hanging around. And it's not only one person, it's thousands of persons multiple times. So we start using this evil that is now transpiring in our face as a great opportunity. Well, to do what? To heal the planet in itself. And when we give enough of our efforts and energy towards healing the planet, meaning removing all these critters and, let's say, previous incarnations of ours, they were not always good, and they are mostly very, very ill in the sense that they die fast, they do nasty things to another, they do nasty things to themselves, they're greedy, they're selfish. And these, our ancestry becomes almost like a long chain with a big metal ball on the end to be carrying through this life. And that's why people becoming more and more, let's say, as they're getting older in the, you know, agely manner, they become so tired, they become crooked, they become wrinkled, they become absolutely ugly looking. So is this a way out? Is this a possibility for us as a human, you know, being who discovered light, to overcome this evil that we produced, we as a human species? No matter alien parasites or all the other critters, and even some of these fallen high beings. They are not high beings as soon as they fall. So they end up actually below your human abilities to do, to heal. So they have to steal from you in a absolutely huge amounts of attempts to terrify you, to injure you, to kill you, to destroy the environment in itself, to burn the nature, to flood the you know, tsunamis of hundreds of thousands of people die instantly. So these energies were sucked into this dark creature that is not available for viewing anymore. Yet the remnants of our deaths still remained on this planet. So this, let's say, clearing process that we are doing, I tell you, it takes a toll on one's body, on one's really ability to comprehend how ill we were as a humanity, how disconnected we were from Prime Creator. Because just realize that one thought of Prime Creator is always in your midst, no matter what and where. Are you in the toilet, or you swimming, or you walking, or you doing your work? It's always there. He's always present. But only if you are present. Only if you have enough courage to recognize that this is it. This is your last incarnation. There's no more corrections after that. Maybe you will do the, you know, another incarnation and you will, let's say, do something different. No, no, my friends. This is it. This is your last physical body. And I can say it could be your first. But to reach this point that your physical body becomes truly pure, you need to work on it. You need to absolutely start clearing it. You need to recognize what you've been ill from, or what you've been sick of. You cannot just claim, I will see my beautiful doctor or a nurse or something, they will save me. They will not save you at all. They were stealing from you. Same as the bankers. They were stealing from you. Same as the freaking politicians. They were stealing from you. Same as the church leaders, they were stealing from you because they were pretentiously teaching you not to be self-sufficient, not to be self-discovering, not to be self-efficient, not to be yourself. They're always pointing you to search for something, solution, resolutions that will be coming from the outside. That was the biggest and the most devious trick that many, pretty much all of us, fall for. Why people cannot look beautiful all the time, for hundreds of years? Because they think they have to apply things from the outside on, like in. Till they realize that the only way is from within out. And doesn't matter what comes from the outside, doesn't matter what kind of evil thing, evil gestures, evil words, evil attacks comes towards you. You know, once when you bright enough and brave enough to use this evil attacks as a great opportunity to become better that you've been yesterday. So be it.